Well, guys, it is time to hydrotest my big green tank. I've featured this tank on this channel a few times. For those of you who haven't seen it before, I'll give you a quick history lesson. This is a steel industrial cylinder. This is a cylinder that was made in the time when ICC, the Interstate Commerce Commission, was the governing body for safety and transportation here in North America. It is a 3A cylinder with a working pressure of 2015 PSI. Here you have the cylinder serial number, and then this is the company that made it, LAP Co. Now, the cool thing about this cylinder is its age. This is the month it was made, and this is the year it was made. So that was made in April 1927. For those of you who just did the math in their head, you would be correct to know that this is this tank's 95th birthday this month in April of 2022. This type of cylinder, just like modern day cylinders, are subject to a hydrotest every 5 to 10 years, depending on the application of the tank. And here you can see that this tank has actually been tested throughout the decades. There's been longer gaps than others here in the lineup of tests, but it has been kept up and used throughout the last better part of a century. Some of you may have also noticed this mark, but it's not what you think it is. Before World War II, lots of cultures throughout history had actually used that symbol as a sign of luck. And in the late 1800s and early 1900s, as high-pressure cylinders started to be created, or at least what was at the time considered a high-pressure cylinder, they would actually stamp that on these tanks as a sign of luck, hopefully keeping the workers around this cylinder safe. But here we are 95 years later, and this tank is still in remarkably good condition considering how old it is. So I bought this tank from the owner of the shop that I work for probably close to 4 years ago, and it hasn't been used in quite a while. It was last hydrotested in 2008 according to these markings, but I bought this cylinder a few years ago. I do hydrotest here at the shop. I think it's incredibly cool, and I want to own one day a 100-year-old cylinder. So right now that it's its 95th birthday, to keep the cylinder happy and healthy, I think it's good that we give it a hydrotest to wake it up, kind of give it a good stretch, and give it a fighting chance to be able to make 100 years old and maybe one day be a historical cylinder. So yeah, let's get this guy ready for a hydrotest. One of the first things we need to do before filling it with water for the test is a visual inspection to make sure the tank is in good condition. So once the camera adjusts here, you'll see there is a bit of surface rust on this cylinder. However, checking it with the gauge and scraping the light against it, I don't seem to find any deep pits. Surface rust inside steel cylinders like this, especially well-used ones, isn't necessarily uncommon, and surface rust isn't bad for the cylinder, but if it is left untreated and it starts to pit the metal, once you start to get an isolated pit or a cluster of pits that pass a certain threshold cutting into the wall thickness, that can condemn a cylinder. As far as I can tell, the surface rust inside this cylinder is mostly just cosmetic. However, after the hydrotest, if it passes, if I want this to be used with breathing gas, I probably will get it tumbled, which is a method of cleaning the interior surface of a cylinder like this to remove any of that surface rust. Next thing is to check the threads of the cylinder, and considering that this tank is almost 100 years old, the threads are actually in really good condition. Again, they've got a little bit of surface rust, but there's no signs of any sort of stress cracks, which is good. This means we are ready to add water to the cylinder. Now that the cylinder is full of water, we're going to install the test adapter. Now that the cylinder is in the jacket, we're going to fill it up and we're going to let the temperature balance out before we start the test. So while we wait for the temperature to balance, let's talk about the rules. So as mentioned, this tank is an ICC cylinder, which means that we actually have to test it based on the specifications it was manufactured to. For ICC tests compared to TC or Transport Canada tests, we are actually going to be testing this at 5/3 working pressure. The working pressure of this tank was 2015 PSI, which means that we are going to be testing it at 3,358 PSI. These types of cylinders, a 3A cylinder, is allowed to have a maximum permanent expansion of 10%. So as long as it passes the test with less than 10% permanent expansion, it is going to be approved for another 5 years of use, which means in 5 years, we are going to have a 100-year-old cylinder. So today is pretty important. I'm pretty hopeful that this tank is going to pass. Especially back then, they didn't really know how thin they could make steel to hold this type of pressure. So there's a very good chance this cylinder is extremely over-engineered, and it's pretty low pressure compared to most modern day cylinders. So we'll see how it goes, but that's why we're here to do the test. And no matter what, we're going to keep this cylinder safe. And if it fails, it fails. Let's see what happens. Okay, so we've been holding zero for 3 minutes now, which means the temperature has balanced out, so we're ready to do a test. Now, before we do it, I'm actually going to do a pre-test to working pressure. This is just going to help wake up the cylinder, give it a better chance of passing hydro, and then I also want to double check that the test adapter isn't leaking. So for the pretest, we're at 2015 PSI, which is working pressure. We have no movement on the burette, which means the adapter is not leaking. So that means we are ready to do a hydrotest on a 95-year-old cylinder. So we're going to start the test over, we're going to release the pressure, and go from there. After the pretest, there was only minimal expansion, which is a good sign and means that this tank is actually pretty healthy. So now that we're back at zero, we're going to start the hydrotest. We're going to turn on the city water, we're going to close the drain, and we're going to start the pump. Okay, so we just hit hydro test pressure, so we're at 3360. We're going to start the timer because we got to hold it for 30 seconds. Our total expansion is going to be at a reading of, let me just readjust this here. Looks like 159 cc's, right on the dot. After 30 seconds, we're still holding pressure. The expansion hasn't moved, so we are now going to depressurize. Now that the pressure is down to zero, we are going to readjust the burette to take our final reading. And it looks like we are at just above 3 cc's. So writing this down, our test pressure was 3360, our total expansion was 159, our permanent was 3, which means our elastic is this number minus that, so our elastic was 156, and therefore the percentage of this is only 1.8%, which means we have a cylinder that has passed a hydro test and is approved for another 5 years of use. I am extremely excited to say that this cylinder is 95 years old, still in working condition. And there we go. I just put on its new hydro stamp showing that it was tested and successfully passed in the year 2022, making this tank 95 years old and still in service. Super cool. And technically, on its 100th birthday, it is going to be in proper working condition, and it's also going to be due for a new hydro test. So it's going to be starting off its next century with a fresh hydro test, with hopefully a big green check mark to give it another maybe 100 years of use.